Welcome, Emmanuel Jell.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I'm looking for some people that's looking for peace. Maybe together we could make the world cease. Set mankind to the moon. We can bridge to the bottom of the sea. That's why it's really kind of baffles me that we cannot end wars or bring peace. We cannot change the way people act. We cannot change the way people think. So if we sit back, chill out and relax, civilization will soon be extinct. That's why I yeah. I'm calling on the whole wide world.
On the whole wide world.
Come on, people. Will you help me?
Help me scream and shout.
Let's scream and shout, cause we want peace.
Let me want peace.
To say the least, I dedicate this song to the common people. Caught in the middle of this common evil. I wish the world was a little bit better. Time we start looking at the man in the mirror. He's their policeman. Fear me with genocide with it so he can. Feel a war of genocide, heaven was wreaking. Silent of the lame, cause nobody was speaking. That's why I yell.
I'm calling on.
Calling on the whole wide world.
On the whole wide world.
Come on, people. Will you help me?
Help me scream and shout.
Let's scream and shout, cause we want peace. To say the least, somebody say Dr. Rwanda. And after Rwanda, not far from Rwanda, we're gonna shout for the poor people living in Darfur. The world gone deaf, the world gone blind, the world busy sitting down on the behind. Nobody care about the poor and needy. The busy sucking up to the rich and the greedy. So every hero there's a little I am dreaming. We're gonna shout getting up for sin. One more time, we got no more time. We gotta figure out the way that we can all combine. Like Jericho, the world comes tumbling down. The sun is going to all the cities around. You know what it's worth now. Gotta put our voice to work. We gonna shake down heaven and earth. That's why I am.
I'm calling on
the whole wide world.
On the whole wide world.
Come on, people. Will you help me?
Help me see.
Let's scream and shout. Everybody give a big hand. To say the least. Come on, everybody, come on. Come on, everybody, come on. Hands up. Hands up. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. All right, let me see your peace sign, everybody. Let me see your peace sign. Roll it with me, yeah. We want peace. We are gonna get it. We gonna get it. We gonna get it. We want peace. We are gonna get it. We gonna get it. We gonna get it. Let me hear big peace scream, everybody. We want peace. We are gonna get it. We gonna get it. We gonna get it. Thank you. How you guys doing? I want to give a big thank you to Ivan for making me come to this 30th anniversary you guys are celebrating, you know? And I also want to say a big thank you to the ERC College for making me come and celebrate this big day with you guys. And so I want to begin with a question, and the question would be, who owns your mind? Who owns your mind? Is it fear, worry, anxiety, poverty, chocolate,
Nike, McDonald's. Who owns your mind? Because the battles are fought in the mind and they are won in the heart. And whoever owns your mind owns you and everything you create. What owned my mind in the past was poverty, worry, fear of losing loved ones, trauma. But what dominated the most was trauma. And what is trauma? I call it a mental genocide, an invasion of demons. I call it a soul murder, something that comes and occupies space in your mind. Nothing else matters. But where did it come from? I was born in the most difficult time. My country was at war with itself, and that war reached the core of my family. All my aunties died during the war. All my uncles except two. By the age of 7, my father gave me out and told me I'm going to go to school in Ethiopia, where we had to walk hundreds and hundreds of miles. During that time, my mom too was taken by that war. We made our way to Ethiopia. We were told we were going to go to school, but we ended up becoming child soldiers. Imagine walking miles and people dying on the way. Being in a place where 6, 7 years old, burying their own dead. Somebody die, we dig our own graves, we make our own prayers. And so this at my early stage. I want to do a spoken word called Force to Sin, which is dedicated to a friend of mine called Lual. We're a group of young people between 200 to 400, and we plan an escape from not wanting to be child soldiers. But only 16 people survived that journey. And I want to share this spoken word with you guys. Would you like to join me? And so I want us to do it in a style. Since we're in US, West Coast, you guys love poetry. Especially I heard San Diego love poetry more. Is it true? Like that you guys are the deep guys. Like, you're not into the material things, you're into the peace and love, and, you know? So, if you don't, you guys, I would ask you guys to stand up with me. And when I say forced to sin, you can say forced to sin to make a living. Is that cool? So can we do it? Forced to sin. So put the American swag there. Yes. Forced to sin. Forced to sin. Forced to sin. Sometimes you gotta lose to win. Never give up. Never give in. My dreams are like torment. My every moment. Voices in my brain of friends that were slain. Friends like Lual who died on my side of salvation in the burning jungle and the desert plain. Next was I, but Jesus heard my cry as I was tempted to eat the rotten flesh of my comrade. He gave me comfort. We used to raid villages, stealing chickens, goats, and sheep, anything we could eat. I knew it was rude, but we needed food, and therefore I was forced to sin. Forced to sin. Forced to sin. Sometimes you gotta lose to win. Never give up, never give in. Left home at the age of 7. 1 year later, I lived with an AK-47. By my side, slept with one eye open wide, running dark. Play dead and hide. I've seen my people die like flies, but I've never seen a dead enemy, at least one that I've killed. But still, as I wonder, I wouldn't go under. Guns barking like lightning and thunder. As a child so young and tender, Words I can't forget, I still remember. As the sergeant command raising his hand, no retreat, no surrender. Forced to sin.
Forced to sin.
Forced to sin.
Forced to sin.
Sometimes you gotta lose to win. Never give up. Never give in. Yigish, I cut to the burn of the drum. War child, child without a mama. Still fighting in the server. Yet as I wake this new war, I'm not alone in this drama. No sit or stop. As I reach for the top, I'm fully dedicated like a patriotic cop. I'm on a fight day and night. Sometimes I'm doing wrong in order to make things right. It's like I'm living a dream. First time I'm feeling like a human being. The children of Darfur. Your empty bellies and they're telling that you that I'm fighting for. Left home, don't even know the day I'll ever return. My country's war torn. Music I used to hear was bombs and fire of guns. So many people died that I don't even cry anymore. Ask God question, what am I here for? Why are my people poor? Why and why? When the rest of the children were learning how to read and write, I was learning how to fight. At snails, vultures, rats, snakes, and anything that had life, I was ready to eat. I know it's a shame, but who's to be blamed? That's my story. Forced to sin.
Forced to sin.
Forced to sin.
Forced to sin.
Sometimes you gotta lose to win. Never give up.
Never.
For child soldiers, never give up.
Never.
For working hard in school, never give up.
Never.
For human rights, never give up.
Never.
For refugees, never give up.
Never.
Peace. Well, the journey I introduced to you in the spoken word, I want to share some of the deep part of my journey. But I want to share the lowest point. Apart from being in a battlefield, seeing people die, I was raised really difficult times. First person I ever witnessed shot to me, next to me was when I was 5. My aunt was raped in front of me when I was 5. So my village soul wrote in front of me. But what pictures of the lowest point I've ever been is what I'm going to share with you now. Each one of us will go through difficult times, but our difficult times is our training. The lowest we go, the highest we can rise. And so here, we're between 200 to 400 young people, and when we planned an escape, we were told the journey is going to take us 3 months, but it took us. We were told it would take 1 month, but it took us 3 months. In this journey, we had enough food, so we ate anything that we had on as the journey went on. And when the food was over, we applied the basic soldier skills. Now, here, when somebody die, the vultures try to eat the dead bodies. We shoot the vultures, and we eat the vultures. We were depending on snails, but snails don't show anymore. But here, something happened. Now, cannibalism started. You know, with starvation, the first day you're experiencing it, you have headache. Second day, it'll fade away. Third day, it becomes sweet. So, you're starving, but the body is like you just had a massage. It's paining inside, it's a soothing pain. It's like death is calling you. Now, my senses changed. I sit next to my fellow human being, they smell like food to eat. Then cannibalism started, so some soldiers started eating dead bodies. I didn't want to be seen healing somebody, but I want to do it where nobody's able to see me. And a friend of mine was dying, and I told him, I'm going to eat him. So I told him, I'm going to eat you tomorrow. He looked at me and said nothing. I like sharing this part of my story because I've never experienced something like that. I wasn't used to it. But whenever time I explain it, it's a part that actually inspires me. Everywhere I go, I always compare it. This is where I came. That's the lowest I've gone, and I'm now here. So it gives me hope to move on. Here, what I did is, my mother was a really religious person. So I used to do what she used to do. So I prayed to my mother's God. I say, Mom, God, if you're there, give me something to eat. And if I survive this journey, I am going to tell this story wherever I go. And so, that evening, we put bomb around a young body, another child soldier. We put it in a tree, hoping the hyenas will come at night to eat that dead body. The bomb explodes. But the hyena comes, the bomb explodes, and the hyenas are not hurt. They take the body. So one morning I crawl under that tree hoping I could find pieces of a dead body I could eat that nobody's able to see me. But there was nothing. So I came down, sat next to my comrade, and I had to battle with my mind in the day and also at night. I'd made my prayers one of the nights and hoping a miracle would happen. So part of my mind was telling me, eat your friend. Part of my mind tell me, if you eat, it's going to haunt you for the rest of your life. And so I had a battle with my mind. 11 a.m., when I was about to lose hope and eat my friend, a crow came on top of a tree. And that crow, a child soldier that I thought died, woke up and shot the crow, and it fell between my legs. And he collapsed, so he never lived to eat it. So I was the only one who ate that bird. I ate it from the clothes to the intestine to the feathers. Nothing of that bird was thrown away. And that bird became the bridge of preventing me from eating a human being. And I was lucky. From that time, more miracles started happening. And I ended up in a place called Worth, where I met a British aid worker called Emma McCune. So these are pictures of me. That time, this was in Ethiopia. You can see this little young man there. That was me. I was already trained as a child soldier. And this is my childhood friend. So I was lucky. End up in a place called Worth where I met a British aid worker called Emma McCune. She risked over 150 child soldiers. One of them became me. But she later died. I want you all to look at that picture. You'll never know the potential of any child or any human being unless that child is given an opportunity, or that human being is given an opportunity. To me, I look at it, all these wars that are happening and racism and all of this, there's no racism. What is actually happening is opportunities being prevented and distributed to certain people. That's what all caused this mess. So I look at it, peace is when my belly is full, and peace is justice, equality, and freedom for all. Why would somebody bring in justice? It's because they want to push other people away. Ideologies are created just to put people away. So that those who have a stronger muscle at that moment would benefit. So this woman died, but she put me in school. And now here I am in front of you. So there's a lot of young people here. School is where you're going to discover your potential. So now if you're in school here, that kid. I was promised that I'm going to go to school in Ethiopia, where I ended up becoming a child soldier. And so this is what I'm about. So now my campaign is about peace. So I created something called We Want Peace, where I campaign around the world. So I go to schools, colleges, universities to share my experiences for social emotional learning. But the thing that is I'm doing now the most is my life is art, which is basically, instead of me pushing, going around the world now to talk about peace, now start a new journey and say, look, if you can handle your internal battles, then the outside battles are easy. And so the journey that I've taken now is I'm more interested in what is inside me. I'm more interested in empowering myself, developing my mental power. I look at it, everybody has been hypnotized by their environment. And people, a lot of people are asleep, they're not waking up, or they're not strong enough to overcome the programs given to them by their parents, by their ancestors, and their beliefs. And so this is what I'm gonna talk. So I wanna leave you guys with a message called courage today. But before I do that, can everybody say, my life is art? I recognize my life as a work of art that I create to spark conscious awakening. In this life I'm creating, I am joy,
I am
peace,
I am
patient, I am my purpose, I am abundance,
I am spiritual blessing,
I am wisdom,
I am knowledge,
I am understanding.
I am enough.
I'll share
what I have
with those
in need
of my help.
I am
what I am.
The world
will know me.
The world
will be blessed
by me.
How amazing is that? So how this started is my mother introduced me the secret when as a kid I stole sugar, you guys know, and milk powder. And so my mom came and asked everybody. Because I did it. The thing is, mothers are smart. So all of us were spies to my mom. And so she came and asked me, Jal, did you take sugar and milk powder? I said, Mom, I swear to God, even if you ask Jesus today, I did not. And you know, there was evidence on my mouth. And so my mother got really angry. And she hauled me up, my legs were hanging. You know, in Africa, they have the rights to beat children. There's no something called child abuse, they call it discipline. So she took me to the wall, and I knew that I was going to be beaten. She put me down and said, my son, I don't want to say what you are not. You're not a thief. You're not a liar. So I want you to tell me the truth. Did you steal the sugar and the milk powder? So now I'm scared. If I say yes, then I get beaten. I've already lied. So I was strong to defend my life. But then, after a while, I just said, let me just say the truth. I said yes, and I closed my eyes waiting for slap. And then she said, thank you for being honest, but if you promise that you're not going to steal sugar and milk powder again, I'll give you a secret that will transform your life. Oh, I was so excited for the secret. You know, children love secrets. Just get one of them who's playing a video game, say, I have a secret to tell you. Come, follow me in my room. They'll drop the video game. And then my mom told me the secret is simple. If anybody ever said anything bad to you, say 10 good things to yourself. And since as a kid, I kept that secret until like I was like 33. And I've been doing that things. I'll say good things to myself. It helped me when we raid a village, we do something bad, I would also talk to the village and say, look, I am not what you saw today. I'm actually a good person. I was raised by a very good woman. And I'm going to come back and I'm going to be a part of solution. And so I would apologize that you've seen the bad side of me, but you don't know what my heart. We came to your village because we're hungry. I am not that. And so to now is when I came to realize later, they call this thing affirmation. I don't know how my mother knew about that secret then, but it transformed my life. So for mothers here, take your kids to bed and give them a secret, simple like this. And so this is what I wanted to share with you guys. I want to leave the message courage. And so, and I'll do it quickly. So, what is courage? Can anybody say? What do you understand? Yes.
So courage means you are living out of your life, out of your heart.
You're living out of your heart. So let's give you guys, if you like, let's give a big hand. Come on, come on. All right. So, anybody courage? Did you put your hand up? Yes, okay, let's see. Courage. All right, let's see. Okay, that's what.
What is courage? Courage is the ability to believe that you are greater than anything anyone tells you.
Awesome. One third one, we need another third one. It looked like they're only women. Okay, one courageous one.
Courage is doing something that you're afraid to do.
Awesome, awesome, okay. Okay, we got a fourth one. Okay. Ah, here you go, you wanna say something? All right, this is my son, come on.
Courage is being brave.
Wow, awesome, awesome. You wanna stand up so they can see you? On the chair. Stand up on the chair so they can see you. Wow. Yeah. So that is mini me. His name is Jal and my name is Jal too. So basically, and the way I look at it, courage is the force, the strength, the power inside us that help us overcome fear. For fear will make us see obstacles, but courage will make us see opportunities. So, but how do we gain courage? For you to gain courage, you must have something you believe in. And you must understand that fear is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom. And failure is an infinite source of intelligence. Can I repeat again? Okay, how do we gain courage? You must have something what? Something you believe in. And you must understand that fear is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom. And failure, it's an infinite source of intelligence. So, for what you believe in, you stand up. Because belief makes us stand and fight. You know, belief also makes us afraid to do things. If you believe you're a doof, you're stupid, you'll be a stupid. Is that not true? If you believe you're smart, it is. You're going to be smart. You find a Christian who believes in Jesus, and then you find Muslim, they believe in Allah, and then they believe there is one God, and then there's somewhere they disagree. Oh, he's a prophet. Oh, he's son of God. He's a prophet, he's son of God. And they get hit up. They, but it's the same. The belief is everything. So I want to show you why am I here. So I want us to have a volunteer to write for us 5 belief statements that we're going to recite later, 5 belief statements. That's, what are those 5 belief statements that can unite us? So, anybody want to volunteer? You have a pen and a paper? Okay, you have pen and a paper? All right, so I want to know, what is it, what do you believe? So anybody want to put hand? What do you believe? Okay. Okay, write that, I believe in myself. That's awesome, give me a big hand. Yeah, That's awesome. You know, a lot of people don't believe in themselves. Yeah? Okay, go on. Wow. I believe it. Yes, awesome. Give a big hand. Everybody, if you like it, you give a big hand. We gotta give energy. Okay. Four. She said, I believe in love. Okay. Anybody wanna contribute? What do you believe? Because for what you believe, you'll fight for it. You know? Okay.
I believe I'm important.
Whoa. Wow. Wow. Awesome. Awesome. Yeah.
I believe in forgiveness.
Oh, that's awesome, man.
This is the guy.
Yeah. All right. Okay.
I believe that children need champions.
Wow. Yeah. That's awesome. Okay, anybody? Okay, what do you believe? What do you believe?
I believe in art.
I believe in art. That's awesome. Yeah. So, I believe in justice, equality, and freedom for all. That's one of my beliefs. So, I believe that I'm here for a reason. And for that reason, I'll live for it. You know? So I want to share where my beliefs come from. You know, in the journey that I explained to you, there was a place where we ran out of food. You know? And there were places where there was no water and we're drinking our own urine. But in this place, it was the toughest part of the journey. My little toe from my left here was cut. And every time I tried to walk, it was painful. So there was a child soldier who was with us. He couldn't bear the journey, he shot himself. But he left that thought in my head. I was like 50 meters away from him. Then a thought came into my head. Why don't you do like him? So I look at my future, and I look at it, we're not gonna survive anyway in this journey, so I should just end my life. I look at my past, it was ugly. And I look at my present, my leg was paining. I was starving, there is no water. And so I took my gun, and I cock it with my right leg because my muscles were not strong. So I fired it with my toe. But the bullet failed. And so I stopped there, hanging in, bullet failed. But I did not know that I'd died yet because I had that shock. But the pain began to come back slowly. Then I still realize I'm still standing. But a voice came and said, you are here for a reason. And then I took that voice and said, I believe I'm here for a reason. And for that reason, I am going to stay alive. I'm not gonna end my life in this journey. And so I say that many times until I was almost possessed by the line in my head. And now I took the first step to move on. The leg was still paining. And I took another step, it was still painting, but I've made sure the focus is just in my mind, not about my foot. So slowly by slowly, as time went on, I was just saying that same line. And the pain began to disappear. My leg healed in that journey. And so I could see, like, there's so many things belief can do for us. But the belief is the foundation for us to have courage, as for us to do anything. And so, and I showed you earlier, like, there were, for us to gain courage, we might have something we believe in. And we understand that fear is the beginning of knowledge, wisdom, and failure is an infinite source of intelligence. So I'm gonna pick two parts. I'm gonna pick, for understanding, I'm gonna leave that out. I'm gonna leave wisdom out. But I'm gonna focus on failure and knowledge. Yeah? Can we do that? So that I can save time for us to dance. So, for knowledge, when we're afraid about something, we need to learn it. We should gather some intelligence. When I was in high school, in I'll begin primary school. I fell in love with a girl. Yeah? And so, but I didn't go to school to fall in love with a girl. I went to study. So this girl, her sister was in the same class with me. So I would dream about her. I passed next to her in the school, my leg would shake and I would sweat. And then I said, okay, she's a witch. She's a witch because she has bewitched me so I can fail in class and her sister can pass. And so I started looking for her and chasing her into the girls' room. I was gonna beat her up. I fell down, so I couldn't manage to get her. But somebody told me later, oh, this is called adolescent. When you reach this stage, yeah, your heart will be taken away without your permission. It is fine. And so, because I was focused, I didn't want the girl to be the thing in my head. So I, in my sleep, I'll tell her, get out, don't stay here. No, I came in to study. I did not come to think about you. So please get out of my head, get out of my head. So I'll walk through the forest. I do weird stuff. Finally, I got out of my head. So, and I got her out of my head and out of my heart so that I could focus in school. So, but this same story, it happened again in high school now. Now I understood that this love thing is cool. So I fell in love with another girl, but now I'm afraid to kiss because I knew I'm gonna take her for a date, but I did not know how to kiss. So I did not know how to kiss, so I didn't want to go for a date. So a friend of mine in the school told me, hey, don't worry, let's watch French movies. Okay, so I never saw French movies before, so I went and looked for French tape. So I started watching French tapes, how they kiss, and it was serious. It was almost shocking for us. So. And then I would practice with a pillow. And so in the evening, I'll go to the forest. You know, in the forest, you know, they're like, how do you call it? When you go to the forest, couples in the evening, they hold their hands and kiss. And so I'll go very close and look at how they do it. And then sometimes when they look at me, they get surprised. And I tell them, hey, don't worry, I am doing the research. And so they look at me, I'm doing a research. And so they look at me weird, they see I'm young and me, so they kind of like let me go. So I did that. So what was I doing? I was afraid of what? To kiss somebody, is that not true? So I went and studied how to kiss. Yeah? So then I trained myself with my pillow, yeah? Nobody knows. And also, I used to practice with a tree. So these are the things I'm just showing you. These are the experiences of the past. So that's how it is in life. When we're afraid of something, let's gain more knowledge. Let's study it. Let's find ways to go around it. And then we gain confidence to finally face it. So when the day actually came, I took the girl for a date. We kissed 3 to 4 hours. Yeah? Right. 3 to 4 hours. You guys are still young. You cannot think about these things. So, 3 to 4 hours, there was no weed, okay? There was no alcohol. All we had was a burger and soda, but we got high. It's like we're drunk. We're walking up like drunk. So people get drunk in love. This love thing can get you high if you do it seriously. So that's one story about knowledge. But what I want to share with you guys now, which I want us to end with, and then we can start having music, is say failure is an infinite source of intelligence. Okay. So I want to share with you guys the famous guy, his name is Thomas A. Edison. I love science, even though science hate me. You know, because I used to fail bad in school. I'll explain it later. So, another guy called Nikola Tesla and Thomas A. Edison. I love their stories, but I'm going to talk about Thomas A. Edison for now. So, Thomas A. Edison was kicked out of school He was given a letter, and I'm going to say my own version. I don't know exact words, because now you're in America, you could get sued even though he's not here. So, just to clear myself, the way I understand it. So, what happened is, he was given a letter and he took it to his mom. The mom opened the letter and started crying. Then the son looked at the mom. Mom, why are you crying? Oh, I'm crying because you're a genius. But what the letter actually says, the letter says he's a doof. Like, he cannot learn, he's mentally retarded, no school here can take him. So that's what the letter was saying. But the mom did not tell the son exactly what the letter says. So the mom used wisdom. Son, there's no school in this area that will take you in because you are a genius. Oh, what is a genius? I mean, you're the smartest child here. There's no school will take you, so I'll be your teacher. Yeah, the kid was so happy jumping around that he's the most smartest kid in the world. So what happened? He paid more interest. The mom started teaching. Later on, the guy was interested in science. And then what did he do? He started loving physics and he became one of the best marketing guy. So he was fascinated by discovering bulb. And so what did he do? He went on a big journey. So in these stories, there is belief. Are you guys tracking? His mom planted a seed of belief in him. But here, Thomas invented a bulb. Then somebody told him, you failed 10,000 ways to get the bulb. He said, no, I didn't. It's just 10,000 ways that did not work. You understand? So in his logic, so when we should never be afraid. When you fail, you're smarter than someone who didn't fail. At least you have some wisdom. Is that not true? So let me show you my failure story. When I was in high school, myself, I was given a grade called UN. And I was so excited. So this is United Nations. So I went home, I showed the grade. The person said, do you understand what this grade is? Yes, UN. And he said, this grade means unclassified, ungraded. And I told him, do you mean I pass so well that I can't be graded? He said, no, you are below fail. Fail is better. And you know, in Africa, it's different than here. When you're so fail, you're stupid, useless. They add so many big words that like you just go down. Get out of here, you useless. What are you gonna, you go to school and so that was really bad for me, it hurt me. And so, how many kids here in school fail and don't want to go back to school? So I told Yalion, I love sciences, but sciences hate me. So in the school, there's physics, maths, chemistry, biology, pick them. All those sciences, I got UNs. And so here I locked myself in a room and I started talking to myself. I said, I believe I'm here for a reason. And I believe I'm going to be a part of a solution. So physics, maths, chemistry, you're not going to be in my way. Even English, I got a UN in English. Imagine going to school and you repeat a class 3 or 4 times. How would you feel? So what happened is here I have my belief that, so in the room where I was called useless failure, so the thoughts come. I say, hey, you're a failure. According to who? According to the school standard, yes. I failed because I did not know. But when I know, I will pass. Now those kids and everybody who's laughing at me have never fired a gun. If I turn up with a gun, everybody will fly. So it's always good to talk with logic. When anything talk to you in your head in a bad way, get logic, talk back. So I would do mental war in that dark place. When I lose, I go look for an old person, massage their feet, they tell me a nice story, I get energy, go back then fight in my head. So finally, I convinced myself to go to school. And I say, I'm going to go back to school. But this time, I am going to fail. So I made my mind to fail. Because before I did, you know, I was below fail. So I went to school. I went to school. I got a couple of UNs, Ds, Es. So I was admitted at the University of Westminster in England with a D, E, and a C. So At the University of Westminster, I still believe I'll beat physics and I'll beat maths. Yeah, I got maths 100% in a university and 98% in physics. Do you see the power of belief? So you gotta believe. When you believe, your entire body begin to work around it, begin to change everything. And so that is it for now. But I want to show you the cool things that I'm doing now with my life. So I go to schools, or I do leadership workshops where I help people find their purpose and also help them own their mind or discover what they were created for, create habits for themselves. I want to share a little story here. I was planning to build a school and put kids in school that time, and I ate one meal for 662 days. Now, see, this is a purpose-driven course, 662 days, eating one meal a day. And now when I talk to the kids and I tell them, hey, I've been eating one meal a day so that your school can be built. And what kids say, what are you talking about? We eat one meal a day anyway. So I was embarrassed. And I told the kid, hey, look, the place I come from, people die of fatness. And the kid looked at me, what? So he went and called the other kids who were playing on the field. Come. Jal is saying there's a story. There's a place where people die of fatness. So they came and they were gathered around and they said, and the kid said, do you mean in that place there is so much to eat that they grow fat and die? And then I said yes. For like 5-7 seconds, one kid put his hand up slowly and said, that is the coolest death ever. So, I mean, fat, growing fat in Africa is a legacy. There's even fattening competition. But because war has happened, those fattening competition never start. So for me to tell them the logic, like they had their own way of explanation. So I finally built the school. But I thought I would share that story with you. So there are a lot of good things. I came from the bottom like a lobster, now rolling on the top like a rock star. Did a movie here with Reese Witherspoon called The Good Lie. I'm now a recording artist, doing good stuff for myself. So I'm now an entrepreneur. I have superfood I've created, which you're gonna know more about later. So you've heard about this. I'm on social media, you can catch up with me. But I want us to do the five belief statements that we just wrote down, and then we can party. Yeah? Is that cool? Five belief statements that we can party. But before we do this, yeah? So we're gonna stand up and we're gonna call this lady here to come and read them for us. So she'll say, I believe, and then we say, I believe. Okay? So you guys hear what I'm saying? Yeah, so let's stand up, and then after that, when she's done, we're gonna have music. I'm gonna pick some volunteers to come on stage. I'm gonna call, yes, come on stage. Okay. Atoma, can you bring with, come with them, yeah, bring. Okay, you can come on stage. All right, yes, my brother. And so we're gonna pick Ivan. I heard he's a great dancer, by the way. Yeah. Ivan, come on stage. Yeah. Yeah. All right. You guys, come on stage, guys. There's the insurance, don't worry. All right, we need some more volunteers. You wanna join us? Or you're taking photos? Okay, yeah. All right. Atongo, come join us. All right, cool. All right, who else? Yeah, awesome. So those two guys, you guys are very cool. Three of you. You? Yeah. Both of you, yes, three of you. One, two, three. Yeah. All right, yeah, I heard you're the best wallow low dancer in the world. All right, come on, join. All right, so who? Yes. Okay, you, two of you, you guys are awesome. Join us. Yes. Yeah, three of you. Yes, beginning with you coming like that way, yes. Yeah. And Olivia, come and say, okay, can young man come? Yeah, come. All right, everybody else can stay here. So here, okay, everybody grab your babies. I mean your phones. Because you know, a long time ago, people loved babies, then dogs took over, and now phones have become the new babies. Every second somebody's looking for their phone. You've not heard these stories? Mothers forget their kids in the shopping center looking at the phone. The kid get lost. So, do this. As you leave out tonight, this celebration should not remain here. Yeah? How many promise that will go and share something that touched them today? How many will do that? So you can share that on social media. That's activism number one. Number two, I would ask you to take 30 days to do something good, either to environment or to a human being, without expecting anything in return. A challenge for 30 days. Who's going to do that? To lead the act of kindness. So you wake up every day and say, I'm going to do something kind. It could be in a restaurant, you just leave $20 and say, give it to whoever want to eat later. Or it could be you walking on the street and buying somebody a meal. Or for young boys and girls, it could be you going home tonight and cleaning the kitchen. Or you could go and say, Mom, how was your day? And surprise them on a Saturday with a massage. Hey, Mom, I booked you a massage. How did that happen? Myself will massage you. How amazing that. How would your mom feel? And she say, Hawaii? Why are you doing this? Because I love you. What is God to say? Just think that you want something. Yeah? But you tell her, Mom, because I just want to do it. She may even think you're on that. Tomorrow you surprise her with something else and then say, hey, my son has been possessed by love. Doing good things. So, let's do the belief thing. Yeah. All right. Say, I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
In myself. I believe,
I believe
in love.
In love.
I believe,
I believe
I am important.
I am important.
I believe in forgiveness.
In forgiveness.
I believe
children need champions.
We have more. Should I continue?
I believe
in art.
I believe in justice, equality, and justice
for all,
and freedom for all, sorry.
I believe
that I am here for a reason.
Awesome. All right, put your hands like this. Everybody, let's fly. Awesome. So now from here, we're gonna party. Everybody stay up, don't sit down, okay? So, are you guys ready? You wanna party? All right, so let me see, let's say, when I say I throw my hands in the air, you put your hand like this. I throw my hands in the air, I salute if you care. So I throw my hands in the air, I salute if you care. And then we say I 16 times. Yeah? 16 times. 16. So let's go. I 16 times. I. There we go. All right. You guys ready to have fun? Oh, let's drop it. This is my power. I speak truth to power. A line from design. My words cutting iron. My life, I run, I'm freezing guns. You block my way, you burn. Shui wa shan wa shed your girl cup. I come from South Sudan. You grandma, she take my mind. I tell you I will stand. Feet, I'm fighter, I'm a pyre. Pen and paper, my desire. Tell the truth, confuse the lie. I take my rights even higher. I throw my hands in the air. I salute. I throw my hands in the air. I salute. Here we go. Everybody to the side. Move to the side this way. Let me see, like, to the side. She dug out one jump, shall we get tall? She will show your letter and tall. She will show you the kayfall. She will you all away, shall I shit on me? Then you say you're crazy, will I keep your eyes and cook you boo? She don't wear quality races. Mother of time, EX single coexist. Doing all this, it's infinite, the value of this. Doing all this, it's infinite, the value of this. I pull my hands in the air. I throw my hands in the air. I salute. Everybody. This is my power. This is my power. 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 My ow. Ow. Let me see your power sign. This is my power. 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 Everybody, let me see your power sign. Like this. Then jump with me like this. My power, 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 my ow, ow. This is my power. This is my power. This
power, my hour, hour. This is my power. This is my power, power, power.
Awesome. Don't go down yet. That's just the beginning. The party hasn't started yet. All right, everybody look at me, okay? So we're gonna look, I'm gonna show you guys some African dance move, okay? So go with me like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, you can go. One, two, three, four, five, six. Let's say, one, two, boom, boom. All right, let's do it properly. Can you look at me? Can we have fun? Okay, let's swagger like this. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Here we go. One, two, pa 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 pa. One, two, pa 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 pa. One, two, pa 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 pa. Pa. One, two. One, two. One, two. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. All right, Biden. Biden. All right. Let me see your hands, everybody. Yeah. Angan balang siya kuy la tora. Angan balang ya malu syara. I'm playing fresh, I give the best, chill the best, show success, kindness will kill the mess. She's my royal highness, she dance with me with a massive gift, hug me like a baby. I gave my all on me, I'm here, jack on me, I'm here. And I joy the ass, I'm going to let, the runner, the runner, I'm going to let. That's my choir, but I'm a tour, I do my shop, I'm going to go. Now joy the ass, I'm going to let, the runner, the runner, I'm going to let. My father, but I'm a tall child. Here we go, everybody.
She told me to show I'm a power. She told me to show I'm a power. She told me to show I'm a power. She told me to show I'm a power.
Here we go. Let me see your hands, come on. Angan balang siya malo syara. Angan balang siya kuyla tora. Lam niya bur. She say talk, my heart tickles. I smile, she start to giggle. Cute face full of the dimples. Of course I touch an angel. Being in with sad summer. Weather gave me a great favor. We took some time, we went with dinner. That's when I became a winner. Lehe, 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 lehe,
lehe, lehe, lehe,
lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe,
lehe, lehe, lehe,
lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe, lehe.
Here we go, everybody, come on.
Back it up, oh, back it up, back it up. Come on, talk, come on, talk, come on, talk.
One more time.
Back it up, oh, back it up, back it up. Come on, talk, come on, talk, come on, talk, come on, talk.
And then balang siya kuyla tora. Let me see. Are you having a good time?
And then balang siya kuyla tora.
Say I
roll. Yeah, she say so.
And your girl
say so. She told me to show I'm a power.
Everybody, let me see your hands. Come on.
She told me to show I'm a power.
Your power sign. Let me see.
She told me to show I'm a power.
Yeah.
She told me to show I'm a power.
Here we go. Everybody, here you go.
Back it up, back, oh, back it up, back, back it up, back. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Back it up, back, oh, back it up. She told me to show I'm a power. She told me to show I'm a power.
One more time.
She told me to show I'm a power. She told me to show I'm a power.
Yeah, everybody.
Back it up. Oh, back it up.
Let me see both of your hands like this. All right, turn around. Turn around this way. Turn around. Yeah. All right, one more time. Let me see your hands one more time. All right, go down. Down, 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 up. All right, let me see. All right, go with me this way. One more time.
good time. All right. All right. Everybody, I want you to look at me. I want to show you a new dance, okay? So stand straight this way. All right. That's what you gotta do. That way. Down, up, down, side, ha, ha, side, ha, ha, side, ha, ha, side, ha. We're gonna do it again, okay? Let's do it one more time, okay? You ready? All right, make your pose. Here we go. Now, say ha. Side, side, ha, ha, side, ha, ha, side, ha. Are you guys ready to go? Let's rock it, DJ Baron. Come on. All right. Let me see your hands. Everybody, time to have fun. Here we go.
Oh, do some us. Do some us. Oh, do some us. Hello, hello.
One more time.
Do some bus. Oh, do some bus. Do some bus. Oh, do some bus. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
Here we go.
Shocker, kaber, kaber. Shocker, kaber, kaber. Shout out to the hero, get it. With my hands, I got it. Bit confused, but I'm not. Let me tell you, stress come by, I rock with a beat by. But yet I'm all up on my tie. I smile, I laugh, I wink my eye.
Do some bus. Oh, do some bus. Do some bus. Oh, do some bus. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hey, baby. 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 Hey, baby.
Hey, baby.
Do this way, this way, this way. I do this way, this way, this way. There's no man, girlfriend gone, boyfriend gone, but shackle name and tell them we have a shot, yeah, we're shot.
Hey!
Oh, do some best, do some best, oh, do some best. Hello, 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 hello.
One more time!
Do some best, oh, do some best. Do some bus, oh do some bus. Hello, 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 hello.
Are you having a good time?
Hey,
as a bumble.
Hey,
as a ganga shabanga 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 shabumba.
Hey,
as a bumble.
Hey,
as a bumble.
Hey,
hey, bule, hey, bule, 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 nanga. Here we go,
everybody.
One more time.
Do some bus.
Let me see both of your hands up, everybody. Can I hear a big scream? All right, put both of hands up, hands up. Go with me like this. Turn around, turn around. Give somebody a high five, high five, high five. Give it up for Athena. Go. Give up, big hand, everybody. Give it up, DJ Paren! Give it up for Anika! All right, give it up for Ivan! Okay, 30th anniversary for Elena Roosevelt College, everybody!
Thank you. We want peace. We are gonna get it. We're gonna get it. We're gonna get it. We want peace. We are gonna get it. We're gonna get it. We're gonna get it. Let me hear big peace.